in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
We honor you, praise you, give you all the adoration. We thank you for a moment, oh God, to learn at your feet. Come and speak to us. Help us, oh God. And I come as Satolia, that as we hear your word, receive the grace also to run with your word,
amen,
such that to deliver the purpose of which it has been sent to our lives.
Amen.
Thank you, Abba Father.
Thank you,
for in Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
In Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Today we're looking at the topic titled, It is Time to Plant. It is Time to Plant. We're taking a Bible reading from the book of Ecclesiastes chapter 3 and verse 1 and 2. To everything there is a season and a time to every purpose under the heaven, a time to burn and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to pluck up that which is planted. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
So today we'll be looking at the topic titled, It is Time to Plant. The Spirit of God is communicating to us today that it is time for us to plant. If we just continue to live without planting, we might end up having anything to avert at some point or in the latter days of our journey, even at the end of our journey. Spiritually, we may have nothing to avert, and physically, we may also have nothing to avert. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
What are the things that we are expected to plant? And what is God trying to communicate to us at this moment that we should plant? Number one, we should plant righteousness. That is supposed to be our way of life. So we should consciously live it out. Yes, we give the Saturni Bashanda. We might say, of course, our righteousness is of Christ, our righteousness is in Christ Jesus. Fine. But we should not also forget that the word of God said that we should all walk out our salvation with fear and trembling. We are not to say because our righteousness is in Christ already, they will begin to live as we like and say, no, we are covered by the righteousness of Christ. No, we in the Sotaya. This our Kuma Satoni Bashanda. Since we have obtained righteousness by the virtue of the righteousness that is in Christ Jesus, our life is supposed to speak it. Our life is supposed to communicate it. Our life is supposed to be an express. Testimony of the righteousness that is in Christ. So, it is time to sow the seed of righteousness. It is time to live a life that will communicate the righteousness that is in Christ indeed that we have obtained, so that at the end of it all, we can reap mercy. Thank you, Abba Father. Why is that about those that in the year of that Marado Shatanika Basanda? Thank you, the man of faith. And another thing that is also expected of us to reap at a time like this is that. To plant is souls. Planting souls is not enough for us to win souls into the kingdom, but to get them perfectly rooted in the word of God, in the things of God. It's not only the work of men of God, of pastors, or teachers, of evangelists, or prophets, or apostles. It's not only their job. It's for all of us. That's why that we should go into the world and make disciples of all nations. The brother that is working in the same place of work with you, in fact, you share the same office, what have you done about his life? Though you can say, oh, he's already a Christian, but how have you influenced him to be rooted in Christ, to well planted and grounded, so that he will not be taken away by the activities of this world? How have you influenced life? Our lives are supposed to be written epistle in Vetoba Santo de Bashanda of the word of God. Our lives are supposed to influence others. Yekida Santo de Bashanda. It's not enough to just tell them about Jesus. It's a Ikeba Soto there. It's to help them also when they come into the kingdom of God to know the ways of God, to understand the things of the kingdom of God, to also help them and encourage them to live Yekiba Santo de Bashanda, the life that is expected of them concerning the kingdom of God and the things and the ways of God, so that they can be truly planted, so that they can also be harvested on the last day. Because any soul that is not planted, that is not well planted, can fall back to perdition. Any soul that is not well rooted in the kingdom of God, when the afflictions of life appear, they can be taken away, they can be distracted, they can be discouraged, they can be afflicted such that they go to Egypt again, they fall back to their former ways to seek help, to even look for help where there is no true help, because the devil does not have any free gift for any man. When he take away headache, he can put cancer there. When he take away back pain, he can even put the Ikeba Santo Libashanda, total final spinal dislocation there. So it is time to plant souls in the kingdom. You can't just plant souls without also evangelizing, without also speaking or preaching the word of God to them. By this, that don't leave a santo, leave a shanda. My kid, a santo, leave a shanda. By it, the santo, yeah, through the words of our mouth, through the ways of our lives, and our acts and dispositions in life. There are many ways that we can win souls and then get them well planted and rooted in the kingdom of God. Yeah, keep us santo, leave a shanda. May kid, a santo, leave a shanda. Has God given any revelation of His word? Any rema, and there are someone close to you that you can share it. Go ahead and share it. And the first person's life positively. Go ahead and share it. And make a depression, a practical, and also be blessed by that which the Lord has given you, or that which you have received in the place of your study, or the place of your encounter with God. Why in the sound to never shanda? When God gives you revelation, don't give it to yourself. It's not for sale. When God gives you revelation, it's not for your personal good, but it's for the body of Christ to be influenced positively. So many souls will be blessed, you'll be blessed, and many other souls that come in contact with you and encounter that word in your life too, to be blessed. So, here in the circle of the making a circle of the heart, we can influence souls, we can get souls well planted and grounded and rooted proper, even taking shoot higher in Christ. Yeah, he keep us up to be a shanda, but our conscious effort towards the souls. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, our Father. Another thing for us to also note now is that it is time to invest into time. It is time to invest into time. It is also a way of planting. He gave us a libato, they can do santali bashanda. He take a booze and die libato santoli kashanda. Thank you, our Father. When you invest nothing in today, into today, you have nothing to reap tomorrow. They give us santoli kashanda high because there is time for everything. Just as the word of God that we have spoken today, there's time for planting. There's time to harvest. There's time to sow. There's time to harvest. When you don't sow today into the time that's allotted to you, at some point in the course of your journey, you see that your life is empty. You see that you have nothing to show for your entire journey, and you have nothing to fall back on. When you sow to your life, even in spiritual places, when you waste your time and you don't dwell in the place of God, you don't study the word of God, you don't meditate on the word of God, you don't grow, you don't sow to your spirit man, at some point in the journey, you'll be tired. At some point in the journey, you just see that you're just shallow. You're just going like an empty drum. At some point in the journey, you just see that you're fading out of the race. You're not just fitting in. You're not just active again. Because this is the word of God, the rhema of His word, that's supposed to be your strength. You have not taken time to sow it into your spirit man. He gave us time to never shanda. No matter how busy we are, we should still have time for the word of God to be in the soul, the metudna heart, to be planted into our spirit man, so that we can grow by the word, so that at some point in the journey, ye is a totally bashanda heart. Those things that we have loaded in our spirit man can begin to bring result, spiritual results in the form of harvest. Make you a totally bashanda, to profit our destinies, to profit the body of Christ, to profit the work of God. So we should not be too busy for God. Even as men of God, if it's not to leave a son to leave a shanda, as you are busy with souls, we just still have time to continue to also sow to our spirit man in the place of study, in the place of seeking God, in the place of prayer, in the kendosa that put the son to leave a shanda, so that we will not be exhausted, so that we can always have harvest. At this, when the season of harvest will come, because we have seasons of sowing, seasons of harvest, seasons of planting, seasons of harvest, when the seasons will appear, so that we can have something to harvest as what to contribute to our strength to move on, to carry on in the rest of life. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Yeah, give us time to live a shanda. Also, in the physical, there is a time to sow, there is a time to plant, there is a time to put Ikizantoni Bashanda to invest. So as Santoni Santoni Bashanda, when the time of investment comes, don't be slothful. To be slothful means to be lazy. When you are lazy, you will be procrastinating. You will be procrastinating. You will give reasons why those things will not work. You will give excuses that does not really matter. Excuses that you can overcome. You will set them as standard before you. You make everybody believe that this is the reason I don't want to go to this. And you are deceiving yourself. Because when the time of harvest comes, you have nothing to find, to fall back on. You have nothing to show for that this is what I've done with my time. I want us to look at our life today, where we are today, as a result of what I've shown you to time in the past. When the time of investment comes, invest. In concerning the work of your hand, When you know it's time to invest, invest. It's not time to carry your capital and be using it for something else. It's not time to carry your capital and even go and borrow another man when you're supposed to use it for your own business. There's time to, there's a time to lend out. There's a time to also invest with what you have. And there's a time to even keep. It is when it is not time to keep, don't keep. Because at the end of the day, what you have kept will not reproduce, will not be multiplied. I mean, Kebo Santoli Bashanda, what you have kept will not be multiplied. When it is time for investment or planting or sowing, when you call the satire, do as expected of you, you have multiplication in return. That means in the time of harvest, you have more than enough to harvest. Making a sort of Bashanda. Don't say as a Christian, I believe God, I'm believing God, I have faith in God. Faith without works is dead. When it is time to invest in that, invest. Make a sort of Bashanda so that you will not be like a fool, even before the world, this system, even before the children of the world. So that you will not be at the end of the day running to the world to beg for bread. My kids, when it is time to plant, invest, then back it up with prayer. Then you can also have faith in God that this my investment will not be eaten up by caterpillar, by cankerworm, by palmerworm, by any form of devourer. So that at the end of the day, when it is time for the ink harvest, I'll have something to showcase. What you just need to do to understand the time. Because the sons of Asiaka, because they have understanding of time and season, all their brethren was at their command. In fact, when you have the understanding of time and season, all things will be at your command. Because you will know what to do, when to do, where to do. Your ink is sacked to Libra, sank to Libra, Shanda. So that in the time of harvest, you know when we plant, when people are harvesting, it will not grow because this condition. The weather will not favor the growth of what you are trying to plant. There's time for everything. The word of God is coming to you today. That it is time to plant. It is time to plant. You can say I'm not a farmer. What you are doing, you can also plant. Invest. You can say I'm a pastor. So all those investments, I mean, to full time. No. Invest into your time. The time that you have. To yourself, don't be hiding. Invest so that you'll be relevant in the race. So that you don't fade the shooter. Yeah? You don't fade away out of the race of life. When you stop planting, you will only eat the harvest of that which you have planted before now. But when you have exhausted the harvest, there will be a time you begin to fade out of the scene. You can't pretend about it. You can't stand to live, or you begin to try to use some worldly things to cover up. I tell you spiritually, it will be clear. Go to the gate of heaven and to the gate of hell. That you are no more there. That you have not sown where you ought to sow to yourself in righteousness. To circumcise, you have not yet sown where you need to sow to yourself in the place of prayer. You have not yet sown where you need to sow to yourself in the place of study, meditation, and waiting on the Lord for counsel. You have not yet enriched your spirit man in the word of God so that it will show. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Abba Father. It is time to invest. Thank you, Abba Father. The slothful always is the bread of affliction. There is no ideal place for the slothful. It will still show at the end of the day that one has not invested. Many have eaten their seed so that they have nothing to pay and do. to harvest. Maybe God has given you provision to start a small scale business. He said, this is too small. You go ahead and blow the money off. When it is time to harvest, that's what you should do. God has given you a place to start up with some souls. You say, these souls are not plenty enough. And you don't treat them well. You don't manage them well. The time you're supposed to spend grooming them, making them to grow spiritually. So that when they grow, they also be a tool of evangelism to increase the souls that God put in your care. You are not there. You are not doing the job. I tell you, God will take them and give to another that will take care of them better. Wasato liba santo liba shanda. Nekida santo liba shanda. My kid has santo liba shanda. Some are to even sow substance in the house of God to give towards the project of God. But yet, they cannot. Because they cannot just let go. They eat their seed. So that when it's time for harvest, they have nothing to fall back on. They have nothing to harvest. It is time to plant. What is the Lord putting in your heart to plant? Nekida santo liba shanda. Both spiritually, in terms of money, in terms of the work of your hand, in investment and so on and so forth. It is time to plant. It is time to plant. Praise the Lord. The Bible says that seed time and harvest time do not cease. I want us to look at the book of Genesis. Genesis chapter 8, verse 22. Genesis chapter 8 and verse 22. Why the earth remaineth, seed time and harvest, and cold and heat, and summer and winter, and day and night shall not cease. I read again. Why the earth remaineth, seed time and harvest, cold and heat, summer and winter, and day and night shall not cease. So it's like, he got the person to lick a shanda. It is the setting and programming of God that there must be seed time and harvest time. When you refuse to sow in the time of seed, when you refuse to plant in the time of planting, there will be nothing for you to make. Then keep a start to live a shanda. Then you keep a start to live a shanda. The word God will clearly declare that there is time for winter. There will be winter and there will be summer. It means that those different seasons too, physically, they will favor even physical planting that we do. There's what to plant during summer. There's what to plant during winter. It is time to plant. I want you to study your life. Look at the sun to the bashanda. You might say, okay, I'm a summer and there's nothing to plant. I'll plant in winter. Look inward. Seek God to know what you can plant during winter. What you can plant during summer. Don't waste any time. Because every time that is allotted to us, we give account. Teach us, O Lord, to number our days, that we might apply our hearts unto wisdom. As we live each day, time is going, time is flying. Our journeys, they are measured in time. The journey of life is measured from the day. Even we are conceived, and we are born. And the journey proper starts with us when we are born. And naked, so to hear, and there's transition. We will give account of how we spent our time. We can't say you don't have time. The time you have been given, what have you done with it? We give us to Bashanda. It is time to plan. That Ecclesiastes chapter 3 that you read before, I'll read it again, chapter 3, verse 1 and 2. To everything there is a season, and a time to every purpose under the heaven, a time to be born, and a time to die, a time to plant, and a time to pluck up that which is planted. That's the time of harvest. A time to plant and a time to pluck up that which is planted. So that when you have not planted anything, you have nothing to pluck up. When you have not planted anything, you have nothing to pluck up. When others are plucking, then you'll be a beggar. And the beggar, the borrower, always be at the mercy of the lender. When you give a son to live a shanda, when you decide to be, it's not when you're supposed to be planting. I tell you, you have a manner of delays in life. When you don't do the right thing at the right time, you'll be delayed now. Because you will not get your destination of certain fulfillments right on time. Because the time is supposed to be preparing, planting, doing things that will make you to get into those fulfillments, you are not doing anything. So that you have to start again when another season comes. This way. And some things in the journey of life, they only appear in only one season, once in a lifetime. Some periodically. How will you also know whether that very thing you are playing with now, that God is telling you it's time to plant, will not have a repetition in the journey of your life? Wake up from your slumber. Let's be awakened today. The word of God is coming to us today. It is time to plant. God.
Hallelujah.
So we read the book of Ecclesiastes chapter 5, verse 19 and 20. We read it into Ecclesiastes chapter 6, verse 1 and 2. Ecclesiastes chapter 9, chapter 5, verse 19. Every man also to whom God has given riches and wealth, and has given him power to eat thereof, and to take his portion, and to rejoice in his labor. This is the gift of God. What the word of God is saying here is that everyone that God has given riches, wealth, honor, and even his own portion, that look, you, I give this to you to enjoy the journey of life, to enjoy your labor, that you shall labor for, not being given to another man or stranger or divorce, not coming to take it away in your lifetime, but you also having life, your life not being cut short, to enjoy and to have joy, even in terms of Satolibashanda, in that you shall labor for. You have to say it is a gift from God. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Verse 20, for he shall not much remember the days of his life, because God answered him in the joy of his heart. He will not remember how much he has lived, or the pain he has gone through, the prices he has paid, the difficult situations, because at that moment of his harvest, at that time when he cannot labor again, God will be busy with him. When there was Santo Libashanda, he gave us Santo Libashanda with the testimonies of his harvest, with the gave us Santo Libashanda with harvest from all that he has labored for in life. He gave us Santo Libashanda. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Then chapter 6 and verse 1. There is an evil which I have seen under the sun, and it is common among men. A man to whom God had given riches and wealth and honor, so that he wanted nothing for his soul of all that he desired. Yet God giveth him not power to eat thereof, but a stranger eateth it. This is vanity, and it is an evil disease. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. There's another set of people too. They also have, God has given them wealth. They have ability to sow in the time of their own planting, to labor when they need to labor, to even invest in time. But yet, they have no opportunity, the power to eat of the fruit of their labor, the power to enjoy their harvest was not given to them. Some, their life was shortened. Some, they, in their lifetime, of all the labor for, is taken away by the divorce of life or evil circumstances of life. Mazakota ikibara doshita likaba santa likaba shanda. Thank you, Abba Father. Reiki the zo in the kuta marita santo liba shanda. It is the gift of God to enjoy the fruit of our labor. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So what does that mean? It means that in everything that we do in life, in the time of planting, as we invest into time, as we sow, so that we can harvest, we should not leave God out of the sin. We should not leave God out of the matter, because we need God. We eke santoni bashanda, for us not to labor in vain, for us to have harvest at the end of the day. Neke basanta ya, we need God even to see us through for life. Meke santoni bashanda, for we need God for protection, for defense, for a stranger not to come in and rob us. Yeah, because the enemy have no other mission than to kill, to steal, and to destroy, which is the ancient serpent. Neke basantoni bashanda, we need God. We need God. Don't be too busy for God. Don't say I'm concentrating. Oh, in my company. Oh, in my business. Oh, I'm so busy. Later, don't postpone that which you need to do. Don't let your relationship with God be affected. And also, maybe I'm not yet giving your life to Christ. Don't postpone the day of your salvation. Don't say until I make it, because you don't even know whether you will finish making it. You don't even know whether you will even live after making it to enjoy all the fruit of your labor. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
It is time to plant. The word of God has come to us today. I want us to look into every aspect of our life and do that which is expected of us by the Spirit of God, to plant. Seek God to know what to plant. If you are confused, you don't even know. You know already? Then go ahead, back it up with prayer. Have faith in God, and it shall be well with you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, you have received your word today. Help us, O God, that this word you have heard today, O God, will be, O God, of great benefit to our lives, so God, we help us to know and to plant that which is required of us to plant, oh God, to recognize also, to be vigilant the time of our own planting, to plant so that when the time of harvest comes, we have something to harvest, we have something to fall back on, not just on next year, even in the spiritual treasury, even in the world to come, in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
What is it that is seed in our hand? Help us to recompense the seed. What is it that we need to plant, both spiritually and physically? Help us to recognize which business are we to go into, which trade are we to go into. Help us to recognize which location are we to go into. Help us to recognize, is this someone that wants to go and study? What am I to study so that I will not just run in vain and have nothing to show for at the end of my study? I have nowhere to fit in. Oh, have mercy. Father, help them to recognize, oh God, where did they have to go and settle for, even in their studies and in their vocations, oh God, in every areas of their life. Even when we say, okay, you are called into the vineyard of Christ, wherein has he called you? Don't run another man race. This came of Santoli Bashanda. As many as those that are called are still confused. They are just doing everything that seems right. Father, visit them with the revelation of that which they need to do so that they can sow rightly and appropriately into time. So that at the end of the day, when the harvest of the whole world will come, they will have something to offer. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Thank you, our Father. And above all, the gift to live, to eat, to enjoy. God has granted because of the journey.
Enemies, they see me on the ground like a